It's a story that needs to be told. Call Her Ganda is a documentary about the brutal killing of 19-year-old Filipina sex worker Jennifer Laude after a U.S. Marine discovered that she was a transgender woman. This week, PJ Raval's documentary Call Her Ganda is reaching a bigger audience with its U.S. theatrical release initially in New York, Los Angeles, and San Francisco.
I'm incredibly excited that the film is being theatrically released in the United States, largely because I think movie theaters are one of the last areas where, as an audience member, you have a collective experience. It's incredibly powerful, and I'm really excited that we'll be screening the film nationwide.
Raval not only chronicles the legal and political side of Laude's story, Call Her Ganda also shines a spotlight on the hate, prejudice and violence trans women experience navigating their everyday lives. Raval says the documentary also shows how Filipino LGBTQ plus activist groups came together to seek justice for Laude, and they got it. Pemberton was found guilty of homicide, convicted, and sentenced to 10 years in jail.
This story is about those who are marginalized rising together and having a voice and taking action. And I think that is completely applicable to what's happening here in the United States. So for me, I think this is a great example of what can be accomplished and a way that you see them do it.
Trans journalist Meredith Talusan says Call Her Ganda is a universal story that local trans activist groups can learn from.
We can't just throw our hands up, you know, that we can make a difference, and that, you know, the midterm elections are important, our civic duty to vote is very important, but it's also, you know, it's also very important to continue protesting.
Plans are underway to screen Call Her Ganda on Capitol Hill for U.S. legislators to see. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.
He's a typical father.